It all started here, where I found a stick on the beach. That stick right there. I decided to take that stick home, stick in front of the fire, dry it out real good. Then cut this little nodule off and see if the wood was any good underneath. I just love this saw. Cuts so smooth. And thank goodness, this piece of wood is solid all the way through. Turns out it's a piece of myrtle wood. So then I went down to Walmart, picked up a new machete. I've been wanting to upgrade a machete for a long time. I've seen a few videos and things, and a friend of mine has one that the BLM upgraded. And you know, these cheap machetes, they are just that. They're cheap machetes, but they're very effective, and for the money, you can't go wrong just how they are. But you know, I'm a big guy and I like to customize things, so here we go. Let's see what happens. So behind my bathroom door, I forgot I had this Harbor Freight machete hanging. Another decent machete. Now, I will say these two machetes, although are very similar in size and whatnot, when I tried to drill the holes into the Ozark Trails machete, I went through 4 drill bits, burned them right up, versus the Harbor Freight, and went right through. So the steel is much harder on the Ozark Trails than the Harbor Freight, I will say that. Now, in copying an idea that I got from the BLM and some modifications they make to their machetes, I'm gonna actually put a hilt on my machetes here. BLM actually just puts a piece of flat bar on theirs and bolts it in place. And that's just to keep the guy's fingers from slipping forward when he's trying to do some more fine-tuning work, so to speak. So I'm gonna build some nice hilts. I have this 1/8-inch flat steel that I'm using here, and I'm just gonna grind it up and shape it just like I want it. And here we go. Now that I've got it all cleaned up and the shape that I want it, I'm actually gonna cut a slit down the center so I can slip the blade down in between it. And then later on, I'm gonna weld it in place. It's always fun to make all these sparks. So pretty, so pretty. Fits perfect, nice and tight. This kind of gives you an idea on how it'll look when it's welded. Now, moving back to the handle. Now, I know I'm going to have to cut this thing in half perfectly. The easiest way for me to do that is going to be if it has some flat sides. Now, it's also way thicker around than I really want for a handle, so I'm going to be doing a lot of carving on this, but I'm going to maintain some form of this flat side that I have here. This way, as you can see, it sits nice and flat and stable, and then I'll be able to take that back to the table saw and cut whatever I have left here when I get done chopping away. Oh, this music just starts to make me fall in love with this piece of wood even more as I just watch it form before my very eyes. I fall back in love with the wood again. This is my first time with myrtle wood, and I will say it's a hard wood, but it's very satisfying. The grain pattern in it does crazy things. You think it might be something bad, but all of a sudden it comes out to be something good, and it's just incredible. I'm sorry, I'm lost in watching the video. I hope you are too.
fool's lighter.
I truly love working with wood, if you haven't figured it out. But here's a little precursor to what things will look like when they're all put together. Now, I had to take a week off of this project, and I didn't want these things to curl on me in that week's time. So, you know, this is a piece of driftwood. Being cautious not to mess with the temperament of the steel, I laid my beads down quickly and let the steel cool. I know that this piece isn't going to hold a lot of weight anyways. Now I know freehanding an angle grinder on your blade isn't recommended by most, but I've got a lot of time with an angle grinder, and my edge came out pretty good. Hope you enjoy the shape. I kind of feel like a pirate myself. So using a flux core wire, it gets really messy, so it was quite a bit of grinding. And then after that, I went ahead and polished them up really good with a wheel. You can see there's the original finish and there's the new finish. And I decided to do that with both of them. And there they are, both roughed out with a rough edge on it still, not quite sharp, but still together, ready to start to get to the final aspect of it. After destroying a whole bunch of drill bits, drilling holes for my rivets, I decided to take a file and really get that edge really nice on both blades. I spent a lot of time getting it just perfect. This way, at the end, I can just take my sharpening stones to it and it should just sharpen right up. And if it's sharp enough to cut paper, then it's a great machete. A lot sharper than most you'd buy. I picked up this little sharpener once at a gun show, and it's like a little diamond sharpener. It's amazing. It works really well. I mean, really well. It's still not quite as sharp as I like it, but it'll get there. So time to get the handles on, and basically here I gotta shave some off so there's room for the weld to fit underneath the handle, and then I'll get these things all put together. I've got some brass rivets that I bought that I'm going to actually use to hold this all together. My God, mineral oil, man? Yes, mineral oil. This is a working tool, fool. Not a beauty piece. I want it to feel good in my hand. This is the first time I've ever used any rivets like this. They're awesome. There's a pipe side and a shaft side, and they just slip in together tightly like a male and female should. A bit more sanding to make the edges come smooth and good to the touch. A bit more oil.
And there it becomes art. I wish the lighting would be better, but it's not. So, take my word for it. This is all I used to sharpen them. And look what happens. Paper test. I love it. Don't cut your foot off, fool. And this paper is almost damp. The humidity level is so high here on the coast. Right through, like butter. But the sheath, something to be desired. Lots to be desired. What shall I do? Before figuring out the sheaths, I decided to rush-proof my tools here. This is how I do all of my steel. My uncle taught me this trick on a table saw that we had for over 25 years and never showed a lick of rust. Simple. Rub it with a candle, heat the wax, rub it in. Beautiful. And rush-proof. And then a new trick. The garbage. I always like to use the garbage and a lighter. Cut it out, make it fit. Stick it in, and it will keep the blade from cutting this really cheap sheath. A lanyard, which I decided to upgrade with a more traditional style after, as you will see. But this is a good way to do it. Sewed on this little piece here, made it a little shorter at the same time. This way the machete actually fits inside, and look, it won't fall out. Applied another one to the other machete as well. And there they are, all done. Easy open, a little bit of white paint, help you identify the side. There's the new cord. On the black one here, I actually have a different type of cord. I love these little knots. They're so smooth, you can't even feel them. And then the shock cord instead of paracord. And there's that curved blade. Well, if you made it this far in the video, I thank you so. Please subscribe. I love to get up to 1,000 subscribers. Oh, it would be wonderful. Thank you so much. God bless, and thanks for watching.